So we're here at the western strand of the Papatea Fault today, and it's almost 2 years since the Kaikoura earthquake. Today we're just going to be taking a look around this area, seeing how it's changed since the earthquake occurred. This surface that I'm standing on was formerly the same surface as up there on top of the fault scarp. And during the earthquake, that side of the fault line up there went up about 5 metres. And this side that I'm standing on went up about 3 metres. And in between we have this 2 metre high wall. This mudstone is a very soft rock and it just is falling apart and weathering away. From up here we can see some really good markers of the former sea levels before the earthquake. What I'm standing on at the moment was probably only just above the waves, and these little barnacles down here are an indicator of where high tide used to be. You can see now where the water level is after the earthquake. So here we're down on the rock platform and we're standing in the former subtidal area. And this is the area that uplifted 5.5 metres. When we came here immediately after the earthquake, everything out here was just covered in seaweed, with all sorts of sea creatures in it. This is all that's really left of the bull count now. So this is the holdfast that used to stick it onto the rock. So there's lots of power here. Kina, sea urchins there. Some Cook's turbine shells. What we did see immediately after the earthquake was a lot of fish, and a lot of crayfish in this area as well. So they're not as evident anymore. You can find some little bits of crayfish that's falling apart and the evidence will soon be lost. All we see now is just the remnants, the bare bones of the really rich ecosystem that used to be here. And what will happen in time here is that enough plants will start growing on here and soil will start forming, and this will just become a new part of land.